Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Physics Tricks. So let's start with projectile motions DPP2, and if you want DPP1 you can go into the description and click on the link. You will get DPP1. So in this we have in DPP2 we have the first question. Two bodies are thrown with the same initial velocity at angles theta and 90 minus theta respectively with the horizontal, then their maximum heights are in the ratio. Okay, so two bodies are thrown over here. One is at an angle of theta and other one is at an angle of 90 minus theta, and these two will go and hit somewhere here. So we want what is the maximum height, right? What is the maximum heights ratio? Okay, no problem. So over here what is the maximum height? Maximum height formula is u squared sine squared theta divided by 2g. Okay, now so maximum height in the first case is u squared sine squared theta divided by 2g, and in the second case it will be u squared sine squared 90 minus theta divided by 2g. Now what is sine 90 minus theta? Now sine 90 minus theta we have is cos theta. So u squared cos squared theta divided by 2g, and if we just take the ratio h1 divided by h2, and that is equal to we have u squared divided by 2g into sine squared theta divided by u squared divided by 2g into cos squared theta. So this get cancelled, will have sine squared theta divided by cos squared theta as the answer. So sine square theta is to cos square theta will be the answer. So I hope this is clear. So this is the first question which we have. Now the second question. In this question it is given the range of projectile at an angle theta is equal to half of the maximum range if thrown at the same speed. So range of projectile r is equal to r max divided by 2 if it is thrown at the same speed. So what is the range we have? U squared sine 2 theta divided by what is called as the g, which is equal to 1 by 2. What is the maximum range we have? We have which is equal to u squared divided by g. So this get cancelled, and if you just find out sine 2 theta is equal to 1 by 2. So at what value of this 2 theta? Sine 2 theta is 1 by 2, so it is at an angle of 30 degree. So what is theta then? 15 degrees the angle. So I hope this is clear right now. So our maximum range will be there at an angle of 45 degree. Okay, so you have to remember this, maximum range of the projectile will be at 45 degree. So I hope this is clear. Now the next question. Question number 3. A ball is projected with velocity 20 meter per second at an angle to the horizontal. In order to have the maximum range, its velocity at the highest position must be. Okay. So maximum range will be possible at an angle of 45 degree. Okay, now so maximum range will be possible at an angle of 45 degree. So this maximum range will be capital R, we can say. And they are asking for the maximum range, what is its velocity at the topmost point? At the topmost point it is only the horizontal direction of the velocity will be there. So VH is equal to, we have u cos theta, u is given 20, into cosine of angle between, this is 45 degree and this is 20 into 1 by root 2, which is equal to, this is 10 root 2, which is equal to 10 into 1.414, that is 14.14 meter per second. So this is approximately equal to, we can say, 14 meter per second. So I hope this is clear. Now the next question, question number 4. A particle has initial velocity given and the force given. The path of the particle is, okay, Now, do remember some of the points. First one, if angle between force and velocity is zero, therefore the path of the object will be straight line. Whenever the angle between the force and velocity will be zero, the path will be straight line. Okay, no problem. If angle between force and velocity is 90 degrees, okay, 90 degrees, therefore the path of the object will be path of the object will be circular. Do remember this, circular. Third one, if angle between force and velocity is other than 0 degree and 90 degree, then therefore the path might be first ellipse, second parabolic. So we have to check. Now, how to check whether the angle between these two is what is called as the 90 degree or 0 degree? For that, we need to take the dot product, isn't it? If dot product is 90 degree, sorry, if dot product is 0, it will be what is called as the 90 degree angle, right? If dot product is maximum, then we can say that it is 0 degree angle, okay? Chalo, let's calculate. Force vector is given, and that is equal to 4i hat minus 3j hat, 4i hat minus 3j hat, and velocity vector is given, and that is 3i hat plus 4j hat, 3i hat plus 4j hat. Now, as you can see, if you take the dot product, force dot with velocity, you will get this is 4i hat minus 3j hat dot with 3i hat plus 4j hat, and you will get then 12 minus 12, which is equal to 0, indicates what? Indicates the angle between the force and velocity is 0, indicates the path of object will be a straight line. So, I hope this is clear. So, it's option A, which is the correct option for this question. Now, the next question. A body is projected at an angle 60 degree with the horizontal with kinetic energy K. So, this is the initial velocity supposed to be, and with horizontal it is given 60 degree. Now, when the velocity makes an angle 30 degree with the horizontal, so somewhere here supposed to be its velocity V dash, and at an angle of 30 degree, we need to find out what is the kinetic energy. Okay, so what is the initial kinetic energy we have? Half mu squared is the initial kinetic energy, and the final kinetic energy half mv dash squared we have. That is the final kinetic energy. That is what we need. Okay, no problem. So we'll calculate v dash firstly. How to calculate v dash? V dash, this component we know, and that is u cos 60 degree only. Only this component we need to calculate, right? Only this component we need to calculate. But V dash, this component we have, V dash cos 30 degree must be equal to U cos 60 degree. Now why? Because the horizontal component of the velocity will never change. That's why V dash, this horizontal component must be equal to U cos 60. So from this we can calculate V dash easily. U by 2 into cos 30 we have is root 3 by 2, that is 2 divided by root 3. So we have u divided by root 3. Now if you just put in this final kinetic energy formula, you will get 1 by 2 m u squared divided by 3, which is equal to 1 by 3 half mu squared. What is half mu squared? It is k. So k divided by 3 we have. So option B is the correct option for this fifth question. So I hope this is clear. Now the next question, question number 6. If t1 and t2 are the times of light for two complementary angles, complementary angles as in theta and 90 minus theta. That means if you consider 30 degree, you have to consider 60 degree over here. If you consider 45 degree, you have to consider 45 degree over here. If you consider 15 degree, you have to consider 75 degree over here. Likewise, these are the complementary angles. Okay, the range of projectile R is given by. Okay, so range we have is u squared sine 2 theta divided by g, which is equal to, now sine 2 theta we can write 2u squared sine theta into cos theta divided by g. Now for two complementary angles, time of light is 2u sine theta by g for the first one, and for the second one 2u sine 90 minus theta as in cos theta divided by g. Now if you multiply t1 and t2, you will get it is 4u squared sine theta into cos theta divided by g squared So you will get, now if we divide this two, because we want R in terms of T1 and T2. So you will get R divided by T1 T2 is equal to, this is 2 u squared sine theta into cos theta divided by g into g squared divided by 4 u squared sine theta into cos theta. So u squared cancel, sine theta cos theta cancel. This g cancel, this is 2za. So you will get, this is R is equal to 1 by 2 g t1 t2. So I hope this is clear. 1 by 2 g t1 t2, that is given in option D. So I hope this is clear, right? So complementary angle means what? The angles which are in the form of theta and 90 minus theta are called as the complementary angles. That is 30 degree if you consider, it is 60 degree, 45 degree if you consider, next angle is 45 degree, 15 degree if you consider, 75 degree, theta and 90 minus theta. That is called as the complementary angles. Chalo, next question. Question number 7. A gun is firing bullets with velocity V0 by rotating through 360 degree in the horizontal plane. The maximum area covered by bullets is, okay, so this is the gun. So it is actually what is called as the covering all the horizontal area. So if you want the maximum area, at what angle we have to throw the bullet? At an angle of 45 degree. Maximum range as in the maximum area. Maximum range as in what? This is the radius of the circle. No, so it will this bullet will fall somewhere here. If you want, it is rotating at an angle of 360 degree, right? So 360 degree as in this way, 360 degree. So it will form one circle in a horizontal plane. So this, and this R is the range, and that is equal to the radius of the circle. So this is the range we have. Now range maximum formula is u squared divided by g. So what is equal to, that is equal to u squared is v naught squared divided by g. Then what is the area we have? Area for a circle is pi into r squared. So which is equal to pi into v naught to the power 4 divided by g squared. So answer for this is area A is equal to pi v naught to the power 4 divided by g squared. So I hope this is clear. Pi v naught to the power 4 divided by g squared. So answer for this is option C we have. Now this is question number 8. A grasshopper can jump maximum distance 1.6 meter. It spends negligible time on ground. How far can it go in 10 root 2 seconds? Okay. So over here, maximum distance, as in the maximum range is given. The maximum range will be at 45 degree. So it is u squared by g is equal to 1.6 given. So u squared is equal to 16. So what is u then? It is 4 meter per second. Okay. So this is the value of u. Now what is the total time? That is total time of flight. Total time of flight is 2u sine theta divided by g. So which is equal to 2 into 4 into sine 45 degree, as in 1 by root 2, divided by g is 10. So if you just solve this, you will get this as 8 divided by 10 root 2, which is equal to, this is 4 by 5 root 2. Right, so this is the total time of flight which we have. Right, so total time of flight, and that total time of flight we have, and that is equal to 0.8 divided by root 2. Right now, 0.8 divided by root 2. Okay, and in a time, it is given 10 root 2 seconds. Okay, so grasshopper will go to the maximum distance of at an angle 45 degree, grasshopper as an insect. And this will go to the maximum distance of what we can say, the 1.6 meter, and it will spend minimum time, then again it will go, right? Likewise, how many jumps it will take, 1.6 meter, that is what we have to calculate. So time of flight we know, the time t is equal to, in time t is equal to 10 root 2 seconds, 10 root 2 seconds. So number of jumps, if we want, see, in 0.8 divided by root 2, one jump is there, right? In 0.8 by root 2, one jump. Therefore, in 10 root 2 seconds, how many jumps? For that, what we have to do is this total time 10 root 2 divided by the given time of period, right? Time of flight, that is 0.8 divided by root 2. And if you just calculate this, you will get 10 into 2 divided by 0.8, which is equal to, this is 100 into 2 divided by 8, so which is 2 fours are, and 4 twos are 8, 4 5 hours. That means 25 jumps it will take. So therefore, distance traveled is equal to 25 into 1.6, which is equal to 40. So this is 40 meter will be the answer. So I hope this is clear. 40 meter, that as in the option D is the correct option for the given question. So I hope this is clear. Chalo, next question. Now in this question number 9, it is given two stones are projected with the same speed but making different angles with the horizontal. Their horizontal ranges are equal given. The angle of projection for one is 60 degree, pi by 3 as in 60 degree. For one, it is given 60 degree. So what is the other angle? It must be complementary angle for what is called as the same range. For same range, it must be 30 degree then. The initial velocity is same, right? So I hope this is clear. So this is the maximum height h max for the second projectile, and this is the maximum height for h max for the first projectile. So it is given maximum height for the first one is 102, h max for the one will be 102 is equal to u squared sine squared pi by 3 as in 60 degree divided by 2g, and for the second one h max 2, that is what we have to calculate, x is equal to u squared sine squared 30 degree divided by 2g. If you just take the ratio, 102 divided by x is equal to u squared 2g cancel, sine squared 60 degree is 3 by 2, and sine square 30 is 1 by 2, sorry, it is 4, no? So 4 get cancelled, x is equal to 102 divided by 3, which is 3 threes are, 3 fours are, 34 meter will be the height for the second projectile. So I hope this is clear. Question number 10. A ball is projected upwards from the top of tower with velocity 50 meter per second, making an angle 30 degree. So one ball is there, which is thrown upward, making an angle 30 degree. So this ball will go somewhat like this. We want what is called as the, after how many seconds from the instant throwing will the ball reach the ground. Okay, so time we want. Okay, so to calculate time we need to find the vertical velocity. So what is the vertical velocity over here? It is v sine theta, that is 50 into sine 30 is 1 by 2, which is equal to 25 meter per second. So initial velocity in the upward direction is 25 meter per second. Acceleration in the upward direction is minus z meter per second squared. Then displacement we have is 70 meter. Right now, 70 meter in the downward direction, as in minus 70. And the time we required. So everything we know, this is just like a kinematics. We have s is equal to ut plus half a t squared. So minus 70 is equal to 25 t minus 1 by 2 g into t squared. So minus 70 is equal to 25 t minus 5 t squared. Now if you just take 5 common, it will become minus 5 1s are, 5 4s are, 5 5s are, minus 5 t squared. So 5 t squared minus 5 t minus 14 is equal to 0. So I hope this is clear. No, this is not 5 t squared. It is t squared minus 5 t minus 14. Why? Because we divided by 5, no? So this is the time we have, the quadratic equation in time. So we'll calculate the roots. So t1 comma t2 is equal to minus b, as in 5, plus or minus square root of b squared 25 minus 4ac, that is plus 4 into 14 divided by 2a, that is 2. So 5 plus or minus root of 25 plus 4 4s are 16, 4 1s are 4, so it is 56 divided by 2. So if you just calculate t1 comma t2 is equal to 5 plus or minus root of, this is we have 1381 divided by 2, which is equal to 5 plus 9 by 2 and 5 minus 9 by 2. This minus time not possible, therefore time we have is 14 divided by 2, which is 7 seconds. So answer for this is 7 seconds. So I hope this all questions are clear to you all. Now if anybody has any doubt, they can comment in the comment box. I'll try to reply to that comment as soon as possible. Thank you so much.